Hi, you're on Purple Spot. I'm George. Welcome to a new series where I take you back to basics on system tools. And on this episode, I'll show you how I set up and jazz up my shell terminal for productivity. I'll show you how I leverage on Windows subsystem for Linux, HyperJS, and OhMyZsh to set up a shell terminal on my Windows machine. If you find this and all other stuff on this channel interesting, hit the subscribe button and join me in the journey of learning by doing. So, let's do this. As you might have noticed in my previous videos, most of what I do involve running commands in terminals. I'm a big fan of Ubuntu, so it goes without saying, I set up Ubuntu terminal on my Windows machine. I also like having a shell terminal that is very expressive and informative, just like what you see here. So, let me show you what I do to set this up. The first thing I want to show you is the version of my Windows operating system. So my machine is Windows 10 Pro with 2.1H1 update, which means I have the latest 2021 feature update. This already comes with Windows subsystem for Linux or WSL. So all I have to do is enable the relevant features. So to do this, I need to open PowerShell as administrator, so I have elevated permissions. Right click on this and then run as administrator. So all I have to do is run command to enable two features. One is Microsoft Windows subsystem for Linux and the virtual machine platform. So the next step is very important. After running the command to enable these two features, I need to restart my machine. Now that my machine has restarted, next thing to do is install Ubuntu. So all I have to do is open my Microsoft Store, which is this one, and then search for Ubuntu. I'm going to choose the latest version, which is 20.04. And then click install. And then now let's click launch. And then now I'll set my default username and provide a password. And now I've got Ubuntu on my system. In as much as I love Ubuntu, there are actually available tools and add-ons out there to help me jazz up my terminal. Like allowing multiple tabs as well as terminal colors and icons to get more context related information, among other things. And I use HyperJS for this. So let me go ahead and close my Ubuntu terminal, close Microsoft Store, and then open my browser. And then I'm gonna go to HyperJS website. So what I need to do is download and install this on my machine. So the installer has been downloaded. Let me double click this to start installing the application. So you will notice what appears to be a green UI while the installation is in progress. So while that's running, let me go ahead and close my browser because I don't need that anymore. So after the installation, HyperJS terminal opens up automatically, and at the moment, my default shell opens to a regular Windows command shell. I can just type bash in here to switch to bash shell, but what I want is to always default to bash when I open Hyper. So what I will do is go to edit and then go to preferences, which will open the configuration file in Notepad. So in this file, I need to go to the property called shell. And I need to update this to point to the bash binary path, like what is provided in this line in here. So all I have to do is copy that and then replace the two tick marks. Close this file, click save to save my changes. And then you'll notice a few prompts in there indicating that you've made changes to the configuration file. So what I need to do next is close this terminal. Now if I open a new terminal, it opens it up with a bash shell by default. At this point, all that's left for me to do is install and set up the main components that I need for jazzing up my terminal. So these components include OhMyZsh, Power Level 10K theme, and some other useful plugins to make my terminal more expressive and informative and useful. And to install the rest of the components for my terminal, I've actually written a bash script to take care of all these required download and installations. So let's quickly talk through what the script does. So let me open my browser. And let's load the contents of that script, which is located here. The first part of the script installs the Z-shell binary, git, as well as wget. The second part runs the actual installation of OhMyZsh tool. I'll put a link in the description on the GitHub repo for OhMyZsh for you to check out. And then the third block installs and sets up the Power Level 10K theme for the Z-shell. There are other available themes out there that you can actually use, but I've always been happy with this theme, so I stuck with it. Apart from installing the theme, the rest of the block in here configures two plugins that I find very, very useful. And these plugins are for syntax highlighting and command suggestions. This next part of the block downloads font files that will be used by the terminal. So these font files will be stored in a temp directory on my machine. And these will allow icons to be displayed on my terminal to jazz up the look and feel of my shell terminal. And then the last part of the script updates bash runcom file, or what other people refer to as bash rc, which executes a number of commands when the terminal is started. The first command ensures that the terminal opens the home directory by default, and then the second command is to automatically start the Z-shell. And then the last part is just some useful message to say you need to launch a new terminal to finish up the setup. So let me go ahead and run this. Copy this and then go back to my Hyper terminal. Now I'm gonna run my script. Enter my password. So the installation has been completed. Next thing I do is install the font files that are downloaded by my script. So let me go ahead and close this and then just quickly have a look at the script. The font files are actually saved inside mntc temp, so I need to go open my Windows Explorer, go to C drive temp, and then I need to install all these four font files. So to install them, just basically double click each one of them and then click install. Installing these font files are optional. However, the icons will not be displayed properly on your terminal if these fonts don't exist on your system. So to show you what I mean by these icons, let me switch to the sample terminal that I have open here. So you see the Ubuntu icon as well as some Git icons on the terminal. And there's also some information in there on the branch of the Git where I am, as well as some time information. So if you don't have these font files installed in your system, you won't be able to see all of these icons on your terminal when you start using OhMyZsh and Power Level 10K theme. So let me go back to my Windows machine and continue with the setup. I also need to update the font family settings on my Hyper terminal to include this font. So let me open a terminal session. So this is where we start seeing the font related issues start to manifest. The prompt is asking if we're seeing a diamond, but because we don't have the font set up on HyperJS, we are seeing a different icon, which is just like a square icon. So to fix this, I open preferences. In the font family property of my config, I need to add a new font in here called Meslo LGS NF. Make sure that the new font that you're adding in here is inside the tick marks. Now I'll close this config file, save my changes. The screen has re-rendered and now I can go ahead and finish the setup. So this will let me go through a series of prompts that will let me choose options to set the look and feel of my terminal. Now my terminal looks like this. So if I now create some work-related directories here, and then try to clone a Git repository, and then cd to that directory of my Git repository. So my terminal will look like this. And as you can see, it's very expressive and informative. It tells me that I'm actually inside a Git repository, and then it tells me that I'm running inside an Ubuntu terminal, and it gives me some time-related information. That's it. As usual, share your thoughts in the comments below. Send me some likes and share this video if you think someone else might find it useful. And if you could, subscribe and help me spread out the word about this channel. Until next time, stay safe. See ya.